Night for Thursday, March the 11th. I'm Colette Linden.
I'm Craig Huckerby. We have some strong winds tonight, maybe some flurries, but it's not all bad news. I have some good-looking weather for the weekend.
Mayor Christian Provenzano offered a statement on the National Day of Observance, acknowledging that today, 1 year since COVID-19 was declared a global pandemic, that the district of Algoma has lost 4 lives. He offered his deepest condolences to all of the family members and loved ones affected by these tragic deaths. In recognition, flags at the Civic Center are flown at half-mast today. Mayor Provenzano went on to say that the past year has been challenging for everyone in the community. He recognized the tremendous commitment to public health and significant sacrifices made by people across Sault Ste. Marie. Mayor Provenzano's full speech can be found on SiouxOnline.com. The Ontario government will continue to focus on protecting people's health and jobs through the COVID-19 pandemic when Peter Bethlen-Falvey, Minister of Finance and President of the Treasury Board, releases the 2021 Ontario budget on March the 24th. The budget will support the province's comprehensive vaccine distribution plan, along with providing additional resources for the healthcare sector and initiatives to protect the economic well-being of families, workers, and employers. Ontario reported another 1,092 cases of COVID-19 on Thursday, while public health units administered a record high number of vaccine doses. The 40,610 shots given out yesterday are the most on a single day so far and come as a pilot project to give 194,500 doses of the AstraZeneca vaccine to some adults through pharmacies and primary care providers begins in earnest this week. A total of 281,000 people in Ontario have now had both shots of a vaccine, according to the province's health ministry. The new cases reported today include 293 in Toronto, 199 in Peel Region, 79 in York Region, and 48 in the Thunder Bay area. The health unit with the highest number of active COVID-19 cases per capita. Locally, Algoma Public Health has 4 active cases with 1 patient hospitalized. Beginning today, Thursday, March the 11th, some groups are welcome to book an appointment for their COVID-19 vaccination, but due to a high demand for vaccine, the phone lines will be busy and appointments will be filling quickly. Please do not call or book an appointment unless you are eligible under the listed category posted to SiouxOnline.com. If you have booked an appointment and you are not on the eligibility list, you will be turned away when you arrive at the vaccination site. You may be required to show proof of eligibility. For all your details regarding eligible groups, please visit SiouxOnline.com. On the advice of the Chief Medical Officer of Health, the Ontario government is activating an emergency break in the Public Health Sudbury and Districts region and moving it to the grey lockdown level in the Keeping Ontario Safe and Open framework. The decision was made due to the concerning trends in public health indicators and in consultation with the local medical officer of health. Based on the latest assessment of data, the emergency break is being used to stop the spread, guard against variants, and protect public health and health system capacity in the region. From March 3rd to the 9th, the region's case rate increased by 54.1% to 75.9 cases per 100,000 people. The public health region will move to gray lockdown effective Friday, March the 12th, 2021 at 12:01 a.m. Today, Premier Doug Ford issued a statement to mark the significant milestones achieved since COVID-19 was declared a global pandemic by the World Health Organization on March the 11th, 2020. Ford offered his deepest condolences to the families, friends, colleagues, and all of those impacted by these tragic losses over life this past year. Over the past year, the vast majority of people who have followed public health restrictions to stop the spread were recognized the extraordinary burden this has placed on individuals, families, and businesses all across Ontario, and the uncertainty created by the pandemic has had a devastating impact on the collective mental health, especially that of young people who have been forced to put their lives on hold, and seniors who have had to isolate themselves from friends and family.
Well, hang on to your hat. It is pretty windy out there. Mother Nature is throwing us back into winter mode just for a day or two, but then she's going to bring back the spring weather on the weekend. I'll give you those details coming up.
By one of our 3 Sault Ste. Marie locations. You do life, we do taxes.
Hmm. Don't click it, Mike. It's a scam.
Oh, hi, Voice of Reason. It looks legit.
Don't click. Listen to your Voice of Reason before you act.
I deleted it.
Canada.ca/bscamsmart can help.
Welcome back, everyone. Well, we started seeing those flurries a little earlier than we anticipated, and they are kind of worrying me because they are small little petals right now, and those tend to accumulate. We're hoping they don't accumulate. We shouldn't see any accumulation, but you never know. Mother Nature has her own way of doing things. It is going to stay windy. Conditions will be very windy tonight with gusts up to 70 kilometers an hour. So watch out if you're heading outside. And we're going to see those flurries blowing around for most of our evening tonight. We'll show you that on the radar coming up. But right now, these are our overnight temperatures dropping down to -1 here in the Sault, which means we could see that coating of that fresh snow in the morning. -1 on Mackinac, very cold in Thunder Bay as they're sitting at -12, -8 in Timmins. So we're all kind of cool today as compared to yesterday. This is the radar, and we'll show you the snow coming in right now. Again, it's just light stuff, but it's going to be an annoyance for most of our nights tonight. We're just going to see it blowing around. It's going to make us feel like we're back into winter. But I do have good news. We have some warmer conditions coming for the weekend. We'll take a look now at the systems map for tomorrow. And here's the cold front. It's a very slow-moving system. This is slowly moving to the east, and that's why we're picking up those westerly winds tonight. Very cool conditions, and then we start picking up some southwesterly winds again tomorrow, though it's still going to be fairly cool for our daytime high tomorrow. So this is our forecast for the next 3 days. For Friday, temperatures around the freezing mark. We're going to see those flurries maybe linger into the morning, but we could break out some sun as well Friday afternoon. For Saturday and Sunday, all sun, temperatures back to normal, 5 degrees for Saturday, 2 degrees for Sunday. If we take a look at the 7 day forecast, still looking good for Monday. Temperatures dipping a little bit. We'll work on that over the weekend. And then temperatures rebound a little bit for the week, though we do have another system coming in for Tuesday that could give us another chance of snow. So it's not over yet, folks. It's really usually not over till April. I think we all know that. So that's your weather for right now. Jacob Moore is standing by with all your sports after this break.
When social distancing, remember, stay at least 6 feet away and wear your mask. Help save lives.
One of our three Sault Ste. Marie locations. You do life, we do taxes.
Gary Bettman spoke with the media in a press conference yesterday and addressed the NHL salary cap. Bettman told media that the NHL salary cap will be staying flat for a while. Looks like it's going to stay right where it is for the next 3 to 4 seasons. Bettman says this is because teams have not been able to have fans in the stands from the NHL bubble last season and the current season right now. Currently, there are teams who are having some fans in the arena, but nobody is able to sell at full capacity. There are currently 13 NHL teams that would be over the projected salary cap for next season.
Hey David, is this about the OHL?
The Ontario Hockey League return to play is back on the table. Lisa McLeod, during a press briefing about Ontario tourism, was asked about the Ontario Hockey League.
I'm feeling great right now. I know that there are still a few outstanding details with the Ministry of Health and the Chief Medical Officer of Health. My team is feeling very confident that we've got the OHL to a place where they would be able to safely play with contact, providing certain conditions. And so asking folks just to wait over the next 2 to 3 weeks. We know that they'll probably also need some financial compensation, so we're looking at what that might be as well. So I'll have more to say on some of the funding for the OHL, but also on when they'll return to play, but I'm optimistic that they will get games in. There will be an additional component to this, however, once we would sign off, if the chief medical officer of health is confident, they will need to go to their local medical officers of health, just as the NHL and the AHL had to do. So there is a lengthy process, but not one that I think is too lengthy that we can't get a season in, as long as the health conditions are right.
Team Jacobs was back on the ice today at the Brier. They played against a wildcard team, Team Howard. The game was a tight game right to the end. However, Team Jacobs just couldn't make a comeback, losing this game 8-6. Jacobs is sitting fourth in Pool A with 5 wins and 3 losses. Stay locked to Sioux Online for all your Brier updates. The NBA has suspended Miami Heat forward Myers Leonard from all activities for 1 week and has been fined $50,000 for an anti-Semitic comment made on Monday. Leonard will also be required to participate in a cultural diversity program. Leonard used an anti-Semitic slur while playing video games and went viral on social media Tuesday afternoon. Within hours, he apologized and the NBA has released a statement. Myers Leonard's comment was inexcusable and hurtful, and such offensive term has no place for the NBA or in our society. The Toronto Raptors will be hitting the court once again tonight versus the Atlanta Hawks. Nick Nurse will be returning behind the bench for the first time since he contracted COVID-19. However, the Toronto Raptors are still missing some key players, including Fred VanVleet and OG Anunoby. Nick Nurse spoke with media about the lineup.
What makes things tough? It's like, it's like they're all out injured, Doug. You know, they're not at practice and they're not playing in games. So you're trying to field the team the best you can and move the next guys up and get them organized and playing, guys that aren't used to playing with each other and playing so many minutes, et cetera. We've just got to try to do the same thing we always do. Learn from the game film. I think getting a belief factor that you can go out there and guard people and execute a defensive game plan and you can score enough. You know, I mean, I think they proved they could score enough at Boston the other night. And can we keep the offensive side of things going and dig in a little bit more defensively here?
Usually the big guys around the basket are shooting those kind of percentages.
Kyle Lowry from downtown. The three is good. Lowry.
USA Basketball has taken a step forward for the Summer Olympics by naming their training camp roster. Two players from the Toronto Raptors made the first cut, Kyle Lowry and Fred VanVleet. Kyle is averaging 18 points and 7 assists per game so far this season. Fred VanVleet is also having a fantastic career season with 20.1 points per game and 6.6 assists. Both of these players are looking to make it to the next cut for the team. The Calgary Flames will be facing off against the Montreal Canadiens tonight. Brand new coach Daryl Sutter will be making his debut once again with the Calgary Flames. Daryl Sutter is still looking to see what this team can really do. He has only been able to have 2 practices with the team, and tonight is his first big step.
The Flaming Sea back on again. And actually, I've been, the last couple of years with the Anaheim coaches, training camp on the ice, that sort of thing. So, but to come back into the Saddle Dome is special. I think there's some things in there some areas, and, you can't get too deep because you're in the middle. We got 30 games left. You can't get carried away with big changes in terms of system and big changes in terms of personnel, who goes where, all that. I think you have to reinforce and get better at certain parts of the game, that, especially in this division.
Riley with it. Across the Martin with a shot. That's deflected, kicked away by Halibut. Tavares. Prince it back in, score! Austin Matthews takes it by Halibut, and finalists get one by him, and they're down by one with 1:54 to go.
The Toronto Maple Leafs will be getting some help in the lineup tonight. All-star center Austin Matthews did miss practice on Wednesday, but Sheldon Keefe says he's good to go. Sheldon Keefe also let media know that Augustini will be playing his first game tonight for the Leafs. Travis Boyd will be coming out of the lineup. Austin Matthews so far this season has 20 goals and 13 assists. The Toronto Maple Leafs are looking to bounce back after a tough loss to the Jets. We have a very busy night in the NHL with 10 games on the docket. 2 of these games are in the North Division. At 7 p.m., we have the Toronto Maple Leafs versus the Winnipeg Jets. This is the second game of a best-of-three season series. The Jets were able to hold off the high-flying Leafs in the last game for a 4-3 victory. Connor Hellebuyck was rock solid, while Frederik Andersen did not seem to be at his best. The Jets are currently 5 points behind the Leafs for first in the division. The second game we have is the Flames versus the Habs. The Flames are currently 4 points behind the Habs for the fourth and final playoff spot in the North. The last time these two teams faced off, the Flames won 2-0. Jacob Markstrom was absolutely stellar between the pipes. This is a big game for the Flames, as this is Daryl Sutter's first game coaching the team, and he really wants to see what this team is made of. This is the first of a best of three season series. Well, that's it for sports, but Colette has more news coming up right after this break.
When social distancing, remember, stay at least 6 feet away and wear your mask. Help save lives.
By one of our three Sault Ste. Marie locations. You do life, we do taxes.
A heavy police presence was observed Wednesday in the west end of the city. Members from the Emergency Services Unit and patrol units could be seen in the area. Roadways in this area were temporarily shut down, according to social media posts. Also, according to Lincoln Loudett, who is the communications manager for the Sault Police Services, police were on scene near Albert Street in Huron for possible weapons in the area. He said the investigation is ongoing and no additional information was being released at that time. We hope to have updates from the police services on this matter later today. Across the province of Ontario each year, over 1 million people receive home care and community support services, and the need is steadily growing. Enter the Ontario Community Support Association. OCSA is a not-for-profit organization that facilitates support through community-based member organizations who are already providing a wide variety of health and wellness services. Ontario Community Support Association represents close to 230 not-for-profit organizations that provide home care and community support services that help seniors and people with disabilities live independently in their own homes and communities for as long as possible. Take a look for the article Staying Put, posted to Sue Online and Mile Goma, which dives into the work of the Ontario Community Support Association. On March 11th, officers with patrol services charged 23-year-old Andrew Barbeau with impaired driving, alcohol, and drugs. At 3 o'clock in the morning, officers conducted a traffic stop on Willoughby Street. Upon approaching the vehicle and speaking with the driver, later identified as the accused, officers developed grounds to believe his ability to operate a motor vehicle was impaired by alcohol. He was arrested and later provided 2 breath samples into an approved device, registering 2 failed results. He is charged with impaired driving due to alcohol and drugs, and impaired driving alcohol level of concentration 8+. He is scheduled to appear in court on April the 19th. In a Point to Shen update, the city has responded to Superior Media's Freedom of Information request with an extension of 45 days. They are permitted to do this under the Municipal Freedom of Information Act. City Solicitor Jeffrey King stated the reason for this extension is due to the extensive number of records to be reviewed prior to providing the information. This extension takes us to the beginning of May, lining up nicely with when the city wants the campers to begin removing their property from the site.
Well, Craig, despite the very windy conditions going on, when I looked outside, there's no snow. Well, it's going away. Tell me more about that.
Yeah, I know. We lost a lot of snow last night, or last couple of days because of the warm temperatures and, of course, the rain last night. But you know what? In 1972, on this date, we had 127 centimeters on the ground.
Wow.
Can you imagine?
No.
I can't imagine that. So, I think the snow is going to disappear in the next 10 days myself. So.
I believe that, and so should you. Thank you for joining us today for Thursday, March the 11th. On behalf of Jacob, Craig, and Colette, thank you for joining us, and stay tuned for more news and weather coming right up.